It's Friday, February 16th, 2024. I'm Cal.
And I'm Alex.
And the Worldview begins now.
White no, baby!
Freshman, do you want to be more successful in high school and set yourself up for a greater future? Are you willing to challenge yourself academically and feel maybe you need more help in your classes? If that sounds like you, you should consider applying for AVID. AVID is a fun, helpful, student-successful program that helps White Knoll students become more successful and prepare for college and future careers. Here's some more info.
John Trowbridge. I work with the AVID students here at White Knoll High School. AVID's a great program in that it takes students that are willing to put in the work, the effort to see where that can take them, and we get the opportunity to give them the classes that they need to push them academically so that they can be well prepared for their college and career when they get out of high school.
What's your name?
My name is Lisa.
My name is Zoe.
What's your name?
Carrie.
My name is Marissa Clark.
And what's your favorite thing about AVID?
My favorite thing about AVID is like the opportunity to like collaborate with people. I really think that's really cool. I like it.
My favorite thing about AVID is a lot of like the relationship building that we get. We like meet a lot of new people like going into the class, and then just building like better relationships with people like I never thought I'd be friends with.
We have a lot of days where we just work on school stuff, like catch-up days, and that's super helpful. It also helps us work on like better note-taking, so we're able to take notes better for our classes, which helps a lot.
How does AVID help you with your other classes and schoolwork?
AVID like keeps me like organized and be ready to like pursue other classes and like have structure.
AVID teaches us study skills in which we could apply to our other classes. And just helps us answer questions better and like send emails better and just do everything overall better.
It helps me in my other classes because it keeps me focused on them and it keeps me like accountable.
I really like the people in it. I've met a lot of friends through AVID and we do a lot of like team building activities that allow me to hang out with them.
And why should you join AVID?
You should join AVID because it's really fun to like collaborate with others and to like do these like cool projects and to really learn like to be college ready for the future. So I really like it.
It is so helpful when it comes to future planning. We do a lot of college research and learning about what college we want to go to and the finances of that. So if you want to look more into your future, AVID's a great start.
You should join AVID just because it's a lot of fun. You get to do a lot of things. Like, yes, it's based on like education and being a good student, but it's a lot of fun as well, and we do a lot of fun things.
To do better in classes, to have fun, and meet new people.
AVID is a student success program that spans the whole school, but it also incorporates a class called the AVID elective. In the AVID elective, we learn skills for writing, collaboration, organization, reading, just general stuff that would help you be successful in your other core classes at school. We also do a lot of group work projects, goal setting, reflection, and students get to help each other answer questions for their more difficult classes. So it's kind of having like a study group that helps you, and you have time to do that during the school day.
If you are interested in applying, fill out the application form or email Ms. Stone for more information at astone@lexington1.net. The application is due by February 29th, so apply soon.
Debate Club meets every Thursday from 4 to 5 in Dr. Duke's room. We debate on interesting topics like should we pay for our education. Join us on room 118 on Thursday.
Sign-ups are happening right now for the White Knoll High School Relay for Life team. We raise money and awareness for the American Cancer Society, and we will walk to help fight cancer. The event is Friday night, May 3rd, from 6 to 11 p.m. To join the team, see Ms. Hobbs in room 219. There's a $5 registration fee, and that goes towards the team fundraising.
National Honor Society is doing a canned food drive at for C Place for the month of February. Every 5 cans donated equals 1 hour community service. All proceeds will go to C Place, a youth leadership program that offers support, education, advisement to empower our community. All cans should be brought to room 141.
Ta-da! White Nose Drama Club meets weekly after school on Monday until 5 p.m. in room P110. The Black Box Theater classroom in the PAC, entrance near the 200 hall. Each week we have a student-led theater activities open to any current White Nose High School student. No experience is needed, only an interest in participating in activities with other enthusiastic.
FCA meets each Tuesday morning in the small gym from 7:30 to 8:30. You can show up at any time between these times for open gym breakfast, so much more. We hope to see you there. Everyone is welcomed. Give me my
now
cup
it's time
back.
For, what?
Give me my cup back.
This is mine. You gave it to me.
I want it back.
And now it's time for the pop and flop.
Pop!
Flop. Last week's bop or flop was Fast Car by Tracy Chapman. It was rated a bop by 70% of you.
This week's bop or flop is... Oh my god. Alright, hold on. Alright. This week's bop or flop goes back to 1972 with Superstition by Stevie Wonder. Let's check it out. Now, me personally, I think that was a bop.
I honestly think it's a bop too.
What do you think?
Now let us know if you think it's a bop or flop by going to @WhiteNoleHighSchoolWolfview on Instagram and voting on the poll in our story.
Now it's time for sports.
Our Timberwolf archers traveled to North Charleston Saturday for the Battle of the Fort Bullseye and IBO competition at Fort Dorchester High School. At this event, we placed second in both competitions, shooting a 32-57 score for Bullseye and a 16-25 for IBO, which put us behind the host team.
Tyler Winston shot a personal best bullseye score of 289, which placed second overall. And Haley Rodriguez led our ladies with a 275 on IBO, International Bow Hunting Organization competition. Nolan Gardner was third overall with 280, and Haley Rodriguez placed third with a 273.
Next week, spring sports really start ramping up. Varsity baseball team is at home on Tuesday and starts the RBI tournament on Friday. Softball is at home Tuesday and starts our JV Carolina Invitational Tournament on Friday as well.
There you go. Girls soccer is away on Tuesday and plays in Viking Invitational next weekend. Girls lacrosse is at home on Wednesday and away on Friday, while boys lacrosse is away on Thursday and Saturday.
As you know, February is Black History Month. We're going to take some time each day this month to recognize and learn about influential Black individuals from South Carolina.
Chubby Checker was born in Spring Gully, South Carolina. Singer-songwriter Chubby Checker is widely known for popularizing the twist dance style. Checker is only recorded artist to place 5 albums in the top 12 all at once.
James Enos Jim Clyburn was born in Sumter, South Carolina. He is the U.S. representative for South Carolina's 6th Congressional District since 1993. Clyburn is also the Assistant Democratic Leader since 2011, and he was previously House Majority Whip from 2007 to 2011.
That's Wolfie for today. Have a great day. Go T-Wolves! Should have been like, ta-da!
Shut up.
FCA meets... each Tuesday morning in the small gym from 7:30 to 8:30. You can show up at any time between times for open gym, breakfast, and so much.
Like that made a lot of noise. Can we get